on this day, I marry my hero. By definition, a hero is a man of distinguished courage or ability, admired for his brave deeds and noble qualities. You possess all of these qualities, and so many others. Kindness, acceptance, and patience. For these qualities, I admire you. For these qualities, you are my hero. You show me heroism every day. Nor is there any detail too minute to be rendered insignificant. Your effort is tireless. You are an example to me of how one can love another unconditionally, no matter how challenging it may be. You show me every day how a person can accept another wholly, including the good and the bad. I watch you. I see you do this every day. Whatever your role, father, son, brother, friend, or partner, your dedication to the people you love is astounding. Growing up, I was given a wonderful gift, the gift of safety. No matter what happened in my life, my parents would make it okay. I was loved and cared for. I was safe. As an adult, I have been searching for that same feeling, safety, that no matter what happens to me, I'll be okay. As a mother, I have only dreamed of providing that same gift to my daughter, and now I can. Because of you, I have finally found it. That is why you are my hero. I strive to give you the same in return, and that is my promise to you.
Almost 3 years ago, I was a first thing to make. I was sad, lonely, angry, and most of all, unloved. Then on that one fateful day in Travancore, there she was, sitting alone in a pew, awaiting her turn to speak to the judge about a speeding ticket she received. Just sitting there in her scrubs, a vision of beauty, and in her right then and there, I had to know who she was. She possessed an aura that drew me to her like a magnet. Her big brown eyes and her beautiful smile were breathtaking. I spoke to her, she smiled at me, and it was a feeling I've never experienced before. It gave me a warm, fuzzy feeling inside, which I thought I would have lost forever. And then I realized it was love at first sight. That's when I knew I was going to make you my wife. God works in mysterious ways, and I thank God every day that He let me find Suzanne. She always tells me that I'm her hero for many reasons, but the truth of the matter is that you are my hero. She rescued me from drowning in misery. She gave me a life that I thought was gone forever. Every day I wake up and look over at her in amazement that this wonderful, beautiful, caring, giving woman is going to be my wife. There is so much emotion that runs through me knowing that she said she will be mine forever. I sometimes, still today, have to pinch myself to know that this is for real. There's not a day that goes by that she doesn't do something that amazes me. For instance, a while back, she was making brownies, and I was standing in the kitchen watching her. After the brownies were done, it was delicious. And I asked her, where did you get some cake from? She took out a Sara Lee box and added it to the mix. She laughed so hard because she made it from scratch. And this was something I've never experienced. Over the years, people who never met Suzanne asked me to describe her. The one word that always comes to mind is exquisite. According to Webster's Dictionary, the word "fork" means finely worked or made, keen and appreciative, pleasing because of beauty or daintiness. This is how I feel about her. She is very exquisite. I'm going to end by saying, Suzanne, I love you from the moment I met you, and I feel like it's not left me since. You are my yes, I will take you as my wife to have to hold you forever.
To comprehend not only the spoken word, but the unspoken gestures, the little things that say so much about yourself. The key to love is forgiveness, accepting each other's faults, pardoning his failures, yet remembering what you learned from the mistakes. The key to love is giving, without any thought of return, with the hope of just a simple smile. Always giving in, never giving up. Please join me in prayer. Suzanne, Ronny, we ask you to help this couple always remember when they first met, how the strong love has grown between them. Help this couple work on life and practical things, so that nothing or no one will ever come between them. We ask this couple to have words loving to one another, for hearts always ready to ask forgiveness, as well as to forgive. How this couple comes to stand before you today, placing their marriage into your hands. Please oversee their lives together. Much as you, Suzanne, you, Ronald, openly declared your wishes to be united in marriage, both in the presence of God and before family and friends. Let love and fidelity each to the other. Each confirm the same by giving and receiving rings, changing vows, promises meant to last forever. Authority vested in the under God, you pronounce it. Have a tradition to live up to. May your marriage last as long as it would take to put this class back together. Mazel tov. For the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Ronald, hold on, today and forever.
Ronny and Suzanne, may all your dreams come true. I love you guys.